Hey. So we're back. This debacle, the orangey peely texture that I got going on, the damage because I dropped it, all these different messes. So I just went to Lowe's and I got one of these pads. I've never really used one of these before. This is 220. I was gonna get a 400. In fact, I think I might have gotten a 400. I did. I got a 220 and a 400. I still have, of course, my 1000 and my 2000. And I've still got some 80 left. That's a 2000. This is my 100. I've got all these different grades of sandpapers. And I'm gonna try to smooth off some of these bumps, and then of course I'm going to repaint it. I was told that I probably didn't let the paint cure enough, so I probably won't paint today. I'll probably paint tomorrow and wash it really good, let it sit overnight, and then try the white again tomorrow before I leave for the weekend. So, be back later. Exciting news. This sponge is doing the job. I started here in the back where it really is hidden anyway, and I started going around and it is taking the orange peel off, and this is smooth again and it doesn't look like an orange peel. Some of the black is coming through because obviously I'm sanding down to the black, but with the weathering that I'm about to do, that's okay. It's really doing a great job on making it smooth, taking off those little bubbles, and I'm learning that the sponge technique also, and sanding areas, is great for revealing the black. You can see in some areas, like where did I really sand? There was an area, like right here along the edge. That's just black paint underneath, and I just sanded down to the black, and it just looks like normal wear and tear. It looks awesome. It's gonna really blend into the paint very nice. It's hard to get in here, so I'm just gonna use the sponge on all the raised areas to get the rest of this orange peel off, and then go in with maybe a little bit tougher grit to get inside the middle there. I'm gonna show it to my boy, who's my GML. If he's happy with the paint, then I'm gonna start weathering. It might not need another coat of white, because I was planning on putting another coat of white on top of this, but I don't know if I need it. This is perfect. The number is just perfect. Just rough enough to take off what I need and leave the rest. And it's making me very dusty. I look like I'm a baker. Whatever caused those bubbles underneath, it could have been a lot of different things. Paint not curing, you know, I doubt it was a dirty nozzle, it was brand new paint. You know, too close to the armor, too far away from the armor, pollen in the air, paint not curing, temperature, humidity, I mean, who knows. Armor being dirty, not sand, you know, not washed off enough. Who knows? Oh, so good. I'm definitely going to do this paint scheme of primer, black, white, because as I, you know, as I sand, it shows some black and it looks so cool. This was real and it got bumped or dropped or whatever, that's exactly what would happen. Yeah, that's so much better. Before, when I did this, you could feel the bumps, and it's really smooth now. It looks more like armor. one little area of trouble that I have to get into. I'm gonna use 400 for this. Little tougher than the 200. No, I'm lying. Little less tough than the 200. But I need to get into those grooves. Sprayed, so it's a little thick in here. So, when I was growing up, we played in everyone's yard. Constantly in people's yards. We played football in this lady's yard. We called her Green Lady. She had a green house. Eventually she painted it brown, but we still called her Green Lady. We thought she was a witch, like literally. She was the meanest lady. She wasn't a mean lady. She was somebody's grandmother, somebody's mother. She just had a bunch of assholes playing in her yard. We played in everybody's yard. We jumped on people's roofs, we climbed trees, we did everything. So right now there's a couple kids in the neighborhood and they're freaking around here and they're kind of going in between the cars in my driveway, and I almost just went, "Hey, you kids, get off my property," and I was like, no, I can't be that guy. I'm not gonna be that guy. I can't. Am I the old man now? Am I the old get off my property guy now? Oh my god. So I didn't say anything, just let them go. And I, you know, if they make eye contact with me, that should be enough to make them go away. But I'm not gonna be the crotchety old man, not yet anyway, not at 45. Unless I get too close to my car, then we got a problem. This is awesome. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Somebody is cutting lawn, I think. Sorry about the noise. Yeah, it's too thick in here. It's too slow. Tell you what, I don't know if I could have been happier with this. It's almost weathered already. I could almost leave it like this, I'll be honest with you. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna wash it and go over to Taylor's. And we'll go from there.
Now that I'm inside, you can see how from the sanding how it really kind of gave it a weathered look, especially look around there, that looks really cool. Some gray in the front, some damage down there, right along the seam there. I still got the marks up there where I dropped it, a little bit in the center here, some marks here, on the side there. So I'm going over to see my GML, see if he wants me to add more white, but I have a feeling he's going to say no, because we're gonna weather right on top of this, and the helmet is here, and it's pretty dark. You know, we're going to do a good wash on it, so
I think we're okay. Out here and by the road, I am at TaylorMade Armors, and we are painting again. I sanded. And you can see that we are back to smooth. We don't have, you can still see a little bit of texture, but as I'm painting, it's going away. The top looks way better. That texture is starting, I mean, it looks, you can see that, but, you know, smooth. So we're quite happy with the results here. Sanding was a good idea, getting rid of those bubbles. and then putting the white back on.
Come on, people. This is done. It looks amazing. Don't worry about the little, you know, pieces of whatever. You know, we're gonna get that out, sand that up. But all the orange peel is gone. We've got good coverage. All the damage that was in there is covered up. It is beautifully white. And I'm very happy. On Monday, I will weather it, and it will be all done. Thank you, TaylorMade Armor.